AquarianRadio.com.
Aloha, this is Enki. You know me as Aquarius, and this is our age, the Satayuga. Time to celebrate with us. We have programs on all chakra tantra, love styles and relationship choices, counseling strategies and techniques that you can use at home. We have extraterrestrial radio where we deal with alienology, paranormal people, and we have an experiencers network. We have a section called Ancient Aliens, and the programs therein are Enki Speaks, Nimma, the Mother of Humanity, has her program, and we revise ancient anthropology. And most important of all, we have peace paradigms. Because this is the age of peace, harmony and understanding, sympathy and trust abounding. No more falsehoods or derisions, golden living dreams of visions, mystic crystal revelations, and the mind's true liberation.
I'm Nimma, an extraterrestrial from the planet Nibiru, mother goddess and creator of humanity. I came here 400,000 years ago. I designed human hybrids, blended the right combination of Homo erectus and the genes of my Anunnaki brother Enki, which I mixed in a clay vessel of the earth. I carried this fetus in my womb, gave birth to the first human being. You all carry my mitochondrial DNA. You are all my children. I love you. I have messages for you to civilize your civilization, create a partnership society, balance masculine and feminine, and bring you forth into this golden age of Aquarius.
And here are your hosts, Janet and Dr. Sasha Lesson.
Aloha, this is Sasha. I want you to listen carefully. Nimma, of course, is an emanation of Ki Ra, who is one of the terraformers of this planet. And Janet Kira Lesson is an emanation of Nimma. So when she puts herself in the Nimma part of her being, here's what she has to say to us today in an episode called Soul Beings.
We are beings eternally evolving, learning, growing through lifetimes here on the earth and other planets, realms, dimensions. Sometimes we're light beings, while other times we alter, lower, or raise our vibrational frequencies to merge with bodies or energies in various levels of physical and spiritual manifestation. Eventually, we evolve to the point where we're able to create life from existing matter and energy. As we progress, we learn how to terraform planets. There are those who actually learn how to manifest planets for terraforming by others who are learning to shape the planet's terrain and introduce life forms, which they also create. We, who are inhabiting this lowest dimension of physicality, have a tendency to play victim and blame others for our situation, but actually we are creating this reality. Everything, all, is subjective. It's not only the law of attraction and action, but we actually create even while we exist in the densest of dense forms. We are more conscious of our creative abilities when in the spiritual realm, when we're dead. But we are just as capable of creating in this world. It's just on a more unconscious level. That's why it's so important to manage our emotions, thoughts, and deeds, for thoughts are deeds, and it is by and through our lives and the execution of these deeds that we are judged by ourselves when we die. We are God source, eternal beings continually practicing on a soul level, creating and manipulating energy and matter. We do the same thing here on Earth, using our hands in combination with our minds and will. We become adept at manipulating and controlling those around us through posturing, posing, wordsmithing, smiles, anger, coaxing, conditioning, training, sexuality, and energy. Using all, we continually shift and change things with our minds, adjusting them to our will, rearranging them to suit our needs, wants, and desires. We do the same thing on our soul level by pure will, for we are not incarnated in a mind-brain and are more expanded, able to manifest by pure energy and desire. Here on Earth, we are assisted by our bodies through our brain, our mind. We move mountains. We create massive civilizations, which we frequently destroy with the flick of a button. Bombs, armies, war, biochemical warfare, mind control, designer diseases, drugs and their side effects. Our food, water, soil, and air are laced with chemicals designed to shorten our lives and release toxins, bacteria, diseases, and germs into our bloodstream and bodies. Order, chaos. Order, chaos, cycles endlessly through the years, throughout our lives, providing scenarios for our evolution. What can we do to combat parasitic vampires atop the pyramid with their all-seeing eyes, who consume everything through greed, money, power, sucking us dry till we're all physically, emotionally, morally, and spiritually dead? Our only revenge is to become conscious, awake, and aware within the dream. Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 life is but a dream. True, it is, and we are the dreamer who becomes the chooser by transforming the unconscious to lucid dreams to total awareness, a reality where we are the captain at the helm of the ship. What we perceive, we believe, we conceive, we achieve. If we no longer buy into the Illuminati, creators of the perverted matrix game, they won't have enough players to play their play, operate their version of reality. They know this. We are given free will by Source God. We need venues for physical lives in sentient form for the evolution of our souls. Societies that are too repressive don't allow us to co-create with Source and are no longer viable for creation to sustain or substantiate their existence. We are Source incarnated in souls, spirit, and flesh bodies. We are the perfect hybrid, living in symbiotic harmony for the most part. Souls who cannot adjust to their bodies do not resonate in harmony and subsequently create chaos and harm to themselves and others. Earth is a playground for billions of souls, perhaps trillions since the dawn of time, who come here because it's attractive, like a favorite tourist destination. Conditions are prime for souls to learn, grow, expand, and evolve. A world that's too polluted becomes no longer viable for sentient life. Enough freedom must be given to permit souls to grow and evolve, which souls do by being co-creators with Source. Devolution is death for all life, so the population decreases and souls go elsewhere to gain experiences for their personal evolution. Earth is prime, a mix between good and evil, so there's enough catalyst and challenge for growth. However, the system is becoming too perverse, is in danger of total destruction, too limiting, too restrictive to continue. So either Earth's human systems experience a perturbation to uplevel its perverted system to a higher playing field, or it will self-destruct, sending the energy and beings and the entire system, which is being held captive, back into the cosmos. Back in the cosmos, energy and matter will coalesce and reconstellate into more viable forms and configurations that better serve God's Source, creation, and all its beings, life, and energy forces. God, creation, creativity rules, so diversity continues to diversify. Otherwise, souls stop coming here. No more tourists. It's just too ugly. I believe Earth is too valuable because of her level of diversity, which was created because of her polarity paradigm plus her location in the densest part of physicality, to be permitted to perish. While souls may be able to go to other venues for experiences and evolution, Earth's playing field is so unique, it's just way too precious. We're being watched. I believe we are ripe for intervention from higher evolved beings, many of which are related to us or are part of our soul groups, who experience extraterrestrial lives in between human lives. They are invested, attached, and care about us, for we are they and they are us. We're seeing more and more sightings. Every day, witnesses come forth from all over the world, ranging from above top secret black projects leaders to the average Joe, Jose, or Jin citizen in all walks of life. Putting all together, connecting the dots, we have the true history of the Earth and a potential for a future far brighter and expansive than what could actually be achieved through natural evolution and at a much faster rate. Intervention is actually perfection. It's time we wake up, accelerate, and become a civilized civilization. Literally tomorrow, we could be invited to join the Federation of Planets. Yes, it's perhaps a Star Trekian vision that to many seem unrealistic, yet unless we reach outside the box to the sacred matrix, a divine peace paradigm of love, we're guaranteed to perish if we continue unchecked at this rate. The indicators are here. Proof lies in every direction. Just open your awareness, trust, and believe that we are worthy on all levels. Physical and soul, for life and existence through all time. Access your inner goodness, your inner godness and light. Love one another at all times, always, in all ways, for we are all one anyway. Wake up. Now you remember.
This has been a channeling from Ninma. Stay tuned for Aquarian Radio for more messages from Ninma, the Mother of Humanity.
Thanks for joining us today on Aquarian Radio. We broadcast daily and our schedule is on aquarianradio.com. Listen live by calling 646-649-0893, or you can listen live by calling 646-649-0893, or listen to our archives on aquarianradio.com. Join us again soon, and do tell your friends. The age of Aquarius and the paradigm of peace is now.
Aloha, this is Enki. You know me as Aquarius, and this is our age, the Satayuga. Time to celebrate with us. We have programs on all chakra tantra, love styles and relationship choices, counseling strategies and techniques that you can use at home. We have extraterrestrial radio, where we deal with alienology, paranormal people, and we have an experiencers network. We have a section called Ancient Aliens, and the programs therein are Enki Speaks, Nimma, the Mother of Humanity, has her program, and we revise ancient anthropology. And most important of all, we have peace paradigms, because this is the age of peace. Harmony and understanding, sympathy and trust abounding, no more falsehoods or derisions, golden living dreams of visions, mystic crystal revelations, and the mind's true liberation.
And this has been another episode here at AquarianRadio.com.
AquarianRadio.com.